name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The glory of God. Let us join and sing the hymn. God will make a way where there seems to be no way. God is spirit, and those who worship must worship him in spirit and truth. The glory of God. Let's join in singing the hymn, Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing. Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace. Streams of mercy never cease, call for songs of love's praise. Teach me song ever is amen, sung by failing tongues above. Praise the mountain, things that Mount of thy redeeming cloud. Here I rest my Ebenezer, here thy light breaketh my calm. And I hope by thy good measure, simply to arrive at home. Jesus saw me learn of strangers, wandering all the world of God. He to rest.
rescue me from danger in the most precious blood. Oh, to praise thou render better any announcement to me. Let that grace now like a fetter bind my inner heart to thee. Let me know thee in thy fullness, let me bow thy mighty head, till transformed in thine own image, in thy presence I shall stand.
As we remain standing, let us follow third order of worship. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him, bless his name. For the Lord is good, his steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness generation. O come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would listen to his voice. Who shall ascend the hill of the Lord, and who shall stand in his holy place? Those who have clean hands and pure hearts, who do not lift up their souls to what is false and do not swear deceitfully. To the Lord our God belong mercy and forgiveness, for we have rebelled against him, have not obeyed the voice of the Lord our God by following his laws, which he set before us by servants the prophets. The sacrifice acceptable to God is broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise. Please be seated. Jesus said, come to me, all you that are weary and carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. I will get up and go to my Father, and I will say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. Let the words of my mouth and meditations of our hearts be acceptable to you, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, we have come into your presence and sanctuary to offer you, through our Lord Jesus Christ, our worship and thanksgiving. Help us to make a true confession of our sins and to pray for others as well as for others. Grant that by our listening to your holy word, we may know more truly the greatness of your love and show forth in our lives that fruit of your grace through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love. He will not always accuse, nor will he keep his anger forever. He does not deal with us according to our sins, nor repay us according to our iniquities. For the heavens are high above the earth, so that great is steadfast love toward those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far he removes our transgression from us. The Father has compassion for his children, so that the Lord has compassion for those who fear him. Let us confess our sins in silence. Let us say the prayer together. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your steadfast love, according to your abundant mercy. Blot out our transgression, wash me thoroughly from my iniquity. Cleanse me from all sin, for I know my transgression and my sin is ever before me. Against you, you alone have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and put a new and right spirit within me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation and sustain in me a willing spirit. Amen.
Let me hide myself in thee.
Grant, we beseech you, merciful Lord, to your faithful people pardon and peace, that they may be cleansed from all their sin and serve you with a quiet mind. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We'll say the prayer together. Today is Youth in Search of Meaningful Life. Let us say the prayer together. God of life, we thank you for the creativity, vibrancy with which you enrich young people. We thank you that your son Jesus Christ, as a young person, surrendered his life to your will, that the whole world may find newness of life. We pray for wisdom and understanding, strength and power, vision and dreams to create a world of justice, equality, peace through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reign with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever. Amen. Please be seated now. The first lesson will be read to us. Book of Genesis, chapter 39, 1 to 23.
On this special Youth Sunday, the first Bible reading is taken from the Old Testament, the book of Genesis, chapter 39, verses from 1 to 23. Genesis chapter 39, verses from 1 to 23. Beginning to read the verse 1. Now the Ishmaelites had taken Joseph to Egypt and sold him to Potiphar, one of the king's officers, who was the captain of the palace guard. The Lord was with Joseph and made him successful. He lived in the house of his Egyptian master, who saw that the Lord was with Joseph and had made him successful in everything he did. Potiphar was pleased with him and made him his personal servant. So he put him in charge of his house and everything he owned. From then on, because of Joseph, the Lord blessed the household of the Egyptian and everything that he had in his house and his fields. Potiphar handed over everything he had to the care of Joseph and did not concern himself with anything except the food he ate. Joseph was well built and looking good, and after a while his master's wife began to desire Joseph and asked him to go to bed with her. He refused and said to her, "Look, my master does not have to concern himself with anything in the house because I am here. He has put me in charge of everything he has. I have as much authority in this house as he has, and he has not kept back anything from me except you. How then could I do such an immoral thing and sin against God?" Although she asked Joseph day after day, he would not go to bed with her. But one day, when Joseph went into the house to do his work, none of the house servants were there. She caught him by his robe and said, "Come to bed with me." But he escaped and ran outside, leaving his robe in her hand. When she saw that he had left his robe and had ran out of the house, she called to her house servants and said, "Look at this. This Hebrew that my husband brought to the house is insulting me. He came into my room and tried to rape me, but I screamed as loud as I could. When he heard me scream, he ran outside, leaving his robe beside me." She kept his robe with her until Joseph's master came home. Then she told him the same story. "That Hebrew slave that you brought here came into my room and insulted me, but when I screamed, he ran outside, leaving his robe beside me." Joseph's master was furious and had Joseph arrested and put in the prison where the king's prisoner was kept, and there he stayed. But the Lord was with Joseph and blessed him so that the jailer was pleased with him. He put Joseph in charge of all the other prisoners and made him responsible for everything that was done in the prison. The jailer did not have to look after anything for which Joseph was responsible, because the Lord was with Joseph and made him succeed in everything he did. Here ends the reading. Praise be to God.
Praise be to thee, O Christ. The glory of God. Let us join in singing the hymn, "Be Thou My Vision, O Lord, My Heart."
Be Thou My Vision, O Lord of My Heart, not be of
Second reading is taken from Hebrews chapter 12, 1 to 11.
Today's second reading is taken from the book of Hebrews chapter 12, verses from 1 to 11. Hebrews chapter 12, verses from 1 to 11. As for now, we have this large crowd of witnesses around us, so then let us rid ourselves of everything that gets in the way and of the sin which holds onto us so tightly, and let us run with determination the race that lies before us. Let us keep our eyes fixed on Jesus, on whom our faith depends from beginning to end. He did not give up because of the cross, on the courtesy because of the joy that we waiting for him. He thought nothing of the disgrace of dying on the cross, and he is now seated at the right hand of the God's throne. Think of what he went through, how he put up with so much hatred from the sinners. So do not let yourself become discouraged and give up. For in your struggle against him, you have not yet had to resist to the point of being killed. Have you forgotten the encouraging words which God speaks to you and his sons? My son, pay attention when the Lord corrects you, and do not be discouraged when he rebukes you, because the Lord corrects everyone he loves and punishes everyone he accepts as a son. Endure what you suffer as being a father's punishment. Your suffering shows that God is treating you as his sons. Was there even a son who was not punished by his father? If you are not punished, as all the sons are, it means you are not real sons, but bastards. In the case of our human fathers, they punished us and we respected them. How much more then should we submit to our spiritual father and live? Our human fathers punished us for a short time as it seemed right to them, but God it for our own good, so that we may share his holiness when we are punished. It seems to us at the time something to make us sad, not glad. Later, however, those who have been disciplined by such punishment reap the peaceful reward of a righteous life. Here ends the reading. Praise be to God.
Praise be to thee, O Christ. Now we'll listen to a special song by our youth fellowship members.
Thank you.
song. Listen to the gospel reading, gospel according to St. John chapter 1 verses 43 to 51. Let us stand.
The gospel reading, the third gospel reading for today is taken from John chapter 1 verses 43 to 51. Jesus called Philip and Nathanael. The next day Jesus decided to go to Galilee. He found Philip and said to him, "Come with me." Philip found Nathanael and told him, "We have found the one whom Moses wrote about in the book of the law and whom the prophets also wrote about. He is Jesus, son of Joseph, from Nazareth. Can anything good come from Nazareth?" Nathanael asked. "Come and see," answered Philip. When Jesus saw Nathanael coming to him, he said about him, "Here is a real Israelite. There is nothing false in him." Nathanael asked him, "How do you know me?" Jesus answered, "I saw you when you were under the fig tree before Philip called you." "Teacher," answered Nathanael, "you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus said, "Do you believe just because I told you I saw you when you were under the fig tree? You will see much greater things than this." And he said to them, "I am telling you this truth. You will see heaven open and God's angels going up and coming down on the Son of Man." Praise be to God.
Praise be to thee, O Christ. Please be seated. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today we are celebrating Youth Sunday. On behalf of Pastorate Committee and all of you here, I wish them great success in their life. I was meditating on a book of Ecclesiastes. There, King Solomon, at his very young age, he reflects his life from three angles. One, life without God, life without Christ. What will happen to life? We are living in a time of liminality, uncertainty, and all the problems. God is a must. And secondly, in a troubled world, the absence of God. Absence of God in a troubled world, life. What will happen to people? They lose hope. They lose all the future. Today, that is the world. And thirdly, what happens to people who are in the old age without God? Young people must be wondering why old people go to church. That's the time they totally depend on God. And fourthly, our life at the end, death without God. So with these four points of our life, I call upon Brother Rup Singh for sharing God's word to us. And Rup Singh is known for his work in hospitals during COVID and before COVID also. And I want him to address our youth because he has experienced all these stages in his life. Now I call upon Brother Rup Singh to share God's word to us. As a preparation, let us sing the hymn, "Spirit of the Living God, Fall Afresh on Me."
Spirit of God.
Shalom.
Shalom.
Shalom. I want to thank the Lord and our dear pastor for having invited me to share God's word. God's word is available to each one of us. We have so many Bibles at home. And my dear friends in Jesus, the universe that God created by his command is full of natural resources. Natural resources, light, sound, magnetism, electricity, water, so on and so forth. And do you know which is the richest of these resources? It is the human resource. Is the human resource. And the human being starts as a zygote in the mother's womb. And the period and the phase in which the child grows in the mother's womb is the fastest. And after 9 months of gestation, the child comes out as a fully formed human being and goes on to be a child, a youth, a middle-aged person, and then on to old age. This is the human process. And in this phase of life, the most important phase is the phase of the youth. You know, psychologists, they call adolescence. And prior to adolescence, we have what is called tweens. What is this word, tweens? It is the transition from childhood into teenage. The child is no more cuddled as a child, and the child also struggles when the parents want to hug it and all that. They feel they are independent. And the youth today have a lot of problems. A lot of problems, a lot of challenges, I would say. And the youth are the richest resource of any country. And India, we should be proud to say, we have the largest number of youth. And today's youth are tomorrow's citizens. The responsibility of governing this nation rests squarely on the youth. And the youth, I want to tell you, you are what you are because of what you see, what you hear, and what you read. My father used to say, "Tell me your friends, I'll tell you who you are, what you are." Choose your friends properly. Let them be godly people. And the book of Proverbs, it says about wisdom, how wisdom is important for the human element to grow. And today's theme, youth in search of meaning of life. Youth in search of meaning of life. Let us ask the Lord to help us to understand this great important element of human understanding. Abba, Father, we want to thank you for these beautiful moments you have given us. Yes, Father, without you, we are nothing. All that we are is because of you. You have created us in your own image. You gave us loving parents, teachers, friends, and ultimately you have given us the freedom to seek you or to ignore you. We thank you, Lord, because you are our shepherd. Jesus we place our hands in yours and lead us on to understanding the meaning of the preciousness of life and the meaning of life. Amen. Today's youth and all people suffer from three main challenges. The first is the dysfunctional family. The second one is displaced priority. And the third word is depression. Happy are we, blessed are we, because we are born into Christian faith and we get the Christian nurture right at home. And to help us to understand the problems that the youth face today, with the suggestion of our dear pastor, I'd like to read to you 1 Timothy chapter 6, verses, I'll start from 8 to 14. And having food and clothing, with these we shall be content. But those who desire to be rich fall into temptations and a snare, and into many foolish and harmful lusts, which drown men in destruction and perdition. For the love of money is the root of all kinds of evil, for which some have strayed from the faith in their greediness and pierced themselves through with many sorrows. But you, O man of God, flee these things and pursue righteousness, godliness, faith, love, patience, gentleness. Fight the good fight of faith, lay hold on eternal life to which you were also called and have confessed the good confession in the presence of many witnesses. I urge you in the sight of God, who gives life to all things, and before Christ Jesus, who witnessed the good confession before Pontius Pilate, that you keep this commandment without spot, blameless, until the Lord Jesus Christ appearing. You know, the character of Timothy is fantastic. He is the prodigy of Paul. Paul was disillusioned with John Mark. And then he didn't want to commit the same mistake while dealing with this young man, Timothy. And of course, Timothy had accepted Paul as his mentor. And above everything, in his life, God was number one. He had the fixed priority. Now, think about Timothy. Paul says, you have been brought up in spiritual nurture by your mother, Eunice, and your grandmother, Lois. Both of whom were staunch believers in the Yahweh God. And they brought up this child in God's ways. But his father was a Gentile. He was a Greek. Yesterday, I had been to a party. And I met a couple who were celebrating the first birthday of their second child. The first birthday. The second child was born after 13 years of the first child. It was also a baby boy. And you know what? the mother is a Muslim and the father is a Hindu. Now when the child grows, which faith will he belong to? This is the problem that many youth face. Parents hardly spend quality time with their children, and vice versa. The family togetherness is lost. I remember the days when we five children were to sit around mother in the moonlight, and she used to give you kaituttu. I don't know how many people know about it. And the consumption of food is much more because mother would tell them stories. Bless the children who have had such a background. So, dysfunctional families. You know, the child looks up to the father and the mother. They need to be the role models for their children. I always ask whenever I meet Christians, do you read the Bible every day? Have you completed the Bible? They have time to read novels. Some of the novels are unputdownable. When you start, you will not put it down till you are finished. They are so exciting. But what about the Bible? It's the book of books. And it's actually a library of 66 books written by so many people. So many people. Some were kings, some were shepherds, some were ordinary people, including a Gentile. Luke was a Gentile. And God picked them up. And some were great intellectuals. Daniel. He was a professor, so to say, in the Babylonian university. How much of knowledge he knew of those days? What about Moses? Even he was nurtured in the Pharaoh's palace, and he was exposed to the knowledge of those days. And in the Ten Commandments, he's shown as an architect, building beautiful city of Ramses. Now, who do we look to as a role model? Do not make any human being as your role model. Your only role model is Jesus. And do you have family prayer? If you have family prayer, blessed are you. You know how much of time Jesus spent in prayer? He used to go alone into the desert areas and he would prepare himself in prayer. He would call out to God. Do we have time to pray? Do we pray at all? You know, in prayer, it need not be a lengthy prayer. Jesus says, what types of prayers are not accepted to God? Some people think if their prayers are long, they are not worthy. They are worthless. Sometimes there are repetitions. The same thing you say over and over again. Is God deaf? Certainly not. And you know the smallest prayer, the shortest prayer? Lord, help me. Only three words. Lord, help me. And sometimes when you're in a problem, when you can't even utter these three words, there's only one word, Jesus. He understands everything. So my dear friends, and especially youth, if you're from a dysfunctional family, pray to God that they'll become functional in the eyes of God. And here, in the book of Timothy, we see about wrong priorities. Today is a rat race. You know how people struggle to get good marks? They want to excel in everything. In my days, if a person gets more than 60%, he would be called a hero. In those days, there were two categories, EPS and ECNPS. EPS means eligible for public service. ECNPS is eligible for college and public service. So if you have crossed 60%, you are a first class. And today, 60% above is nothing. You need to be 90, 95, 96, 99. And when the child comes and shows the papa, "Papa, I got 99. Does he appreciate? He said, "You fool, why didn't you get 100? The child, you know, is not encouraged. Very sad. So, we need to have proper priorities. And Pastor very much said a beautiful statement: life without Jesus Christ is nothing. Even in the book of Ecclesiastes, Solomon has enjoyed all the luxuries of life: power, wisdom, and how many wives he had, I don't know the count. But the very same women snatched him away from God. And he comes back to God. So, what are your priorities? Usually when we ask children, "What do you want to be?" They say, "I want to be a doctor. I want to be an engineer." But hardly anybody says, "I want to serve God." You can serve God being a doctor. You can serve God being an ordinary clerk. You can serve God in any capacity in which God has put you. In fact, I wanted to become a preacher, but I became a teacher. But I could reach out to people wherein pastors can't reach. And praise God, I have resumed the hospital ministry. I have been going to the hospitals to pray for the sick people in St. Martha's. And you know what joy it is to pray for others? Pray for others more than you pray for yourself. And when you pray for others, God will take care of you. Because you are concerned about others as God is concerned about them. You know, the theme of a church which I visited was this: that my priority is to know Jesus and make others know Jesus. Is that your priority? Ask yourself. And the last D is depression. You set goals and you do not reach them. You tell yourself, "I want to get 90 plus. And you study. You burn the midnight oil. You keep your textbooks open. And you study. And you know how you study? Many people, they study late in the night. And very few people get up in the morning. Studying in the morning is very much beneficial because the air is fresh, your mind is fresh. But late in the night, your body is tired and you can't concentrate. And you know how you study? The books are open, but your eyes are closed. So also your mind. Very sad. So fix your priority properly and avoid depression. And many people are driven to suicide because of depression. And in many months, we are very much concerned about the youth. because the youth, they are being frisked away by their addictions, drugs, smoking, alcoholisms. So we need to protect ourselves. Praise God, if you are in a Christian family, devoted to God, praising God, worshiping God, and you set your priorities first, seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all these things will be added unto you. Do you pray for God's kingdom? The Jews say the prayer in which you do not mention the kingdom of God is no prayer at all. We pray, thy kingdom come. And his kingdom has already come when Jesus is your king. And protect yourself from all things that distract you from God. Set your priorities right. And when you set your priorities right, Jesus will be your shepherd, leading you on and blessing you. God bless you.
Let us affirm our faith in Apostles' Creed. Let us stand. I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried, descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again, he ascended into heaven, seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please be seated. Friends, once again, on behalf of Youth Fellowship and also Pastorate Committee and all of you, I thank Brother Roop Singh for bringing this wonderful message for youth as well as to us. And he's an experienced person as a teacher and a preacher, and also serving the community with the depressed people and also people who suffer from various problems. And he has guided many people to take life and priorities of life. That is very important. Jesus without life is meaningless. Jesus without troubled time, life becomes meaningless. And Jesus in our old age becomes meaningless. And also Jesus should be there to meet the death and the resurrection. Thanks, brother, for bringing this wonderful. I now call for announcement, church announcements.
We are happy to have you all worshiping with us this morning. We look forward to your continual fellowship in the days to come. Members celebrating birthdays this week: 17th October, Mr. Sunil Christopher W., Mr. Sridhar Rao C., Baby Evita Zoe, Mr. Raleigh Godwin R. 18th October, Mr. William Rodericks. 19th October, Mr. Vijayananda Das S., Mr. Sachin Daniel Pengal. 20th October, Mrs. Vatsala, Master Amaron Manat Paul. 21st October, Mr. Sharon, Mr. Denzel N. Pengal, Master Nischal Alistair Duke. 23rd October, Mr. E.R. Anchan. Members celebrating wedding anniversaries this week: 18th October, Mr. Sandeep Kumar and Mrs. Soumya Sandeep. 19th October, Mr. Gunalan M. and Mrs. Ruth Premalatham. May God bless them all and keep them safe in His grace. Sunday school will start at 11 a.m. Request all the children to join the class through Zoom. Career counseling for all the youth of our church members aged between 18 to 35 will be conducted on 17th November at 11 a.m. at our church premises. Request all the youths to participate and take benefit from this counseling session. All are invited for the weekly Bible study and prayer, which is conducted by a pastor every Thursday evening at 6:30 p.m. Should you have any prayer requests, drop them in the prayer request box kept at the entrance of the church. City Area Women's Fellowship election is on 24th October 2021 at 4:30 p.m. at St. Luke's Church. Request the Women Fellowship members to attend the zonal meeting. Church anniversary will be celebrated on 24th of October 2021. Please collect the scholarship application from the treasurer and submit the application by today evening at 6 p.m. Today will be the last day to submit your application. We request the members transferring money online into the church account to send email to treasurer regarding your transfer so that the treasurer can email you a receipt of the amount. Last week's collection totals up to ₹65,380. Thank you and God bless us all.
I'm happy to announce the new office bearers of Krishnagopalaya. This was held last week. And Mr. Aaron NB, he'll be the secretary. Please stand, Aaron. And Mr. Benjamin Isaac, be the treasurer. And program coordinators, we have two people, Ms. Sharon and Ms. Alice. So they will be in charge of youth programs in our church. Thank you. Please be seated. Let us pray. God, our Heavenly Father, we thank and praise Thee for the wonderful way You are leading generation of people to Your glory at this hour of prayer. Lord, we remember youth fellowship members and also you, they are facing the problems in their life, and those who are taking part in different aspects of life, your faith, attempting great things for God. At this hour of prayer, Lord, we commit our youth fellowship into a mighty hand. Bless them and help them to take your mantle to the next generation, like Timothy, who took their parents' devotion, faith, and priorities for the next generation. At this hour of prayer, Lord, we commit all of our youth members and children into mighty hand. Bless them. So our prayer, we also remember those who are celebrating their birthdays. Give them new spirit, new understanding for new year. Once again, Lord, we commit the families who are celebrating their marriage anniversaries. Bless them and keep them under your guidance. We also remember those victims of problems, disasters, and also disease. You be the Lord, will stretch your healing hand upon them. Give them hope. Reconcile them with your spirit. And we also pray for our nation. It's undergoing tumultuous time. At this hour of prayer, Lord, we commit all the problems, major problems, children, youth, women, and senior citizens. This hour of prayer, Lord, we commit and also submit all our prayers in the name of our Lord and Savior, who brought reconciliation and redemption. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us say Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is. Give this day our daily bread, and forgive our trespasses as we forgive those trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, power, and glory forever and ever. Amen. Our closing hymn is, Take the Name of Jesus with You.
Take it.
Mercy and protection we commit you. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.